Just as a snapshot, you know me very well. In the last 3 years, we were quite conservative in the Ministry of Finance. So most probably, even in 2022, we will have a growth rate above 3.1%. Mm-hmm. So I would like to thank the economists once again for their honorary invitation to today's insightful event. Event which gives us, we have birthdays today as a Greek government, the opportunity and the challenge to share some thoughts regarding the financial landscape in Greece, but also in the Eurozone. After, as you mentioned before, 2 years on crisis, on severe crisis in the fields of health, energy, and geopolitics. These crises are shaping a much more unstable world in which our governments are called upon to work together and develop timely, effective, and far-sighted policies. Amid this crisis and these turbulent times, the Greek economy has demonstrated a remarkable resilience and important achievements, as confirmed by all stakeholders, among others, ESM. This is based on the implementation of key policy reforms on six fields, on six areas, on six pillars: fiscal policies, social welfare, financial stability, labor and product markets, privatizations, as well as the modernization of public administration. Over the last 3 years, despite these challenging circumstances, we have voted 333 laws in the parliament, omnibus laws in the parliament. Thus, we have achieved major economic goals. I will pick up five goals. First of all, growth. The economy is growing. The economy is growing strongly. We achieved a V-shaped recovery back in 2021, while the GDP figures for the first quarter of the year were very strong, 7% year on year, indicating, as I mentioned before, that our current projections for 3.1 growth in 2022 may eventually turn out to be quite prudent. Not only prudent, quite prudent. But the second is much more important compared with the first. The composition of growth is much more important. GDP composition positively changes. While the share of non-tradable services is declining, the share of investments and services is increasing. Indeed, gross fixed capital formation increased by around 13% year on year in the first quarter of the year, while exports of goods and services increased by 10% over the same period. The third factor has to do with the labor market. Labor market developments have been positive. Unemployment continues its decline, being at the lowest level since 2010. Labor inactivity falls, employment increases by double the size of inactivity reduction, while the reduction in unemployment rate among women and youth is more pronounced compared with the reduction in the headline unemployment rate. The fourth factor has to do with the banking sector, and Pavlos can confirm this, NPLs. The NPL ratio has been reduced from 41% in June 2019 to 12.1% in the first quarter of 2022, from 40% to 12%. And finally, public finances. Public finances have resumed their improving trajectory. Both the budget balance and public debt are recording a significant decline. Indeed, public debt to GDP ratio declined by 13 percentage points in 2021, probably according to the discussion that took place at the AWG level, the strongest one-year reduction ever recorded in the history of the Eurozone. We also expect further improvement of our public finances in 2022, with the primary deficit shrinking further to 2% of GDP and the debt to GDP ratio falling by another at least 13 percentage points. All these developments prove the effectiveness of the applied economic policy and the credibility of the Greek government, as reflecting, among others, in the multiplier upgrades of the Greek sovereign from credit rating agencies, as well as the historic decision regarding the exit of my country from the enhanced surveillance mechanism. However, as you mentioned before, we still face lingering uncertainty, significant challenges, and downside risks, relating mainly to energy prices and inflation. This requires persistent reform efforts at the national level, as well as decisive solutions at the European level. We are committed to continue implementing a prudent, reform-oriented economic policy agenda based on six pillars, on titles. First of all, providing one-off support measures, especially for the most vulnerable part of the society, households and enterprises. Second pillar, following a credible fiscal path, mainly based on GDP expansion with higher permanent tax revenues, enhanced by growth-friendly reduction on taxes and social security contributions. Indeed, the European Commission projects that Greece will present the highest primary surplus among 1% among all EU member states in 2023. Third pillar, implementing a smart debt issuing strategy based on low average annual gross financing needs, proactive liability management, and regular market operations so as to maintain substantial cash buffers. Fourth pillar, enhancing liquidity in the real economy through three routes: banks, credit expansion, the development of the loan facility of the Recovery and Resilience Plan, as well as the implementation of the new insolvency framework, which is truly state of the art. Fifth pillar, utilizing public property through the implementation of the Asset Development Plan, as well as of structural reforms. Indeed, we have completed a number of important reforms to digitalize public administration, to reorganize the pension administration, Panos is here, to simplify the framework for investment licensing, to provide a modern corporate governance regime, to establish tax incentives in order to boost research and development, as well as to increase the size of the firms. And finally, sixth pillar, to rationally utilizing the available European funds. The National Recovery and Resilience Plan, Greece 2.0, is in full swing. Today, 230 projects and sub-projects have been incorporated into the implementation phase of total face value around 10.2 billion euros. It is evident that despite difficulties and international volatility, Greece has turned the page. We will certainly continue to work hard in order to overcome the difficulties and strengthen Greece and Europe as a whole. Thank you.